family.
Shout out. What's up, bro?
Yep, yep. How everybody doing?
Doing all right. How about yourself?
I'm good. Everything's good. Everything's good. Yeah, thank y'all for jumping on the call so late. Really, thank y'all for that. You know, as Ray said, he's going to get on in a few moments. He's just taking care of some business right now. He's doing a couple of things at once. You know, but he said he want to talk to everybody. Say, hey, he's been in the hospital the last couple of days. He just want to say, you know, what's up to everybody, check on everybody.
Yeah,
but he said he's doing something right now at this exact moment. He good. He was sick. He had food poisoning. So he was stuck to the hospital for a couple of days. And then he said he went back today again. He thought it may have been a hernia. So he been in and out the last couple of days. So he's trying to get the Suburban still, get that repaired on. He's really trying to get up out of there. So he told us it's going to be a lot of blockage when he tried to come to Atlanta. I mean, more and more blockage, you know.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? Shout it out.
Hey,
Chief.
Yeah,
I'm here now.
Shout it out,
Chief. Hey, what's happening?
Hey,
Man, I'm all right. I'm making it. Shoot, man, I tell you, California's crazy. I got to get out of this place, y'all. This place is outrageous. Yeah, let me tell you something. I survived once again. Tried to get me once again. I got them back, though. I'm alive. They can't stand it. They can't stand it. What's happening, man? Who all on the line? Who's on this line?
Tank.
Huh? Who else is on here with me?
This Roger.
Oh, Polly Ellis on here.
Oh, y'all should see me right now. I got the Protestant thing going on deep. Y'all ain't got no hair dye in my hair. Well, I'm gray hair for real. Yes, sir. I got the Protestant thing happening, y'all.
That's right.
I got to hurry up and put some dye in my hair. Put some dye in my hair quick. Yeah. I don't want everybody to know. Pop's hair is gray for a long time. Did y'all know that?
Yeah.
Did y'all know Pop City is great for a long time? Huh?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
You're lying.
You didn't know?
Yeah, Pop City is great for a long time. You know what I'm saying? Because he used to dye his hair gray all the time. And then what happened was, I think his herbologist, he had an herbologist by the name of Miriam, and she was an excellent herbologist, and she caught him one day. Dyeing his hair. And he said, you think I should let him know now? Keep the secret and let him know later. He said, yeah, keep the secret and let him know later. And so for years, he stayed with black hair, all black hair. And then he took the dye out. Where are y'all? They left already? Oh, God. Hold on. I'm in a store in my company just rolled out on me. I don't know. Oh, God. Sister, can you hit this thing for me?
When I go out
there? No, my family went out without me. Thank you. God bless you, honey. Lord have mercy. Here they go. They had the car ready. Yeah, but what it was is that he kept his hair gray for a long time, and then after a while, he let everybody know. Came out, he was black, all black hair today, and came out all white hair tomorrow.
I heard him say that too. He said, I can change my style anytime.
That's for real. And the thing is, I think I've done it just about the same way. I'm gray, my hair is all white, but I've kept the dyed look. For a little while, I've kept it black. It's been gray now. It's been gray now, all white for a while. But I didn't want to just shock y'all like that. But yeah, the Quaticin thing is in knee deep. But I think I'm just stopping using the name Atunre for a while and just use the word Quaticin. Use the name Quaticin for a while, maybe. I don't know. I think I'm going to keep it black. I'm going to dye it again for another year or so.
I was asking about the herbalist.
About
which herb was used.
Herbologist?
To, yes, the
no,
dye.
No,
herb.
It wasn't that. It was, I just made mention. I don't know what herb they used. I do know all I had made mention of is the fact that when Baba had gotten, when his gray hair had became first noticed, it was noticed by his herbologist, whose name was Miriam. And she was a very nice lady. I knew her personally. She would take care of all my father's herbs needs. And he, I mean, she was about the best one I have seen up to date, too, as far as being, you know, well-studied in the science of herbology. And she's the one who first caught him with his hair all white. You know what I mean? That's what it was. I don't know what herb they use to create the dyes. Everything is created from a plant somewhere. You know what I mean? You just have to know the science of it all. You know, I'm sure we can, if we wanted to know with you know, the touch of a finger, that's why it's all here. Let me tell you something. You know, all of this was created for us to become advanced, to become more advanced, that the faster. That's why this this window symbols thing that I'm doing is very real. I'm going to have to pull together our best computer people. I want our best computer people to be front and center come when I make it to Atlanta. You follow me? When I finally make it to Atlanta, I want our best computer people there, because I'm going to be giving what information I know. I'm about 45% finished with the program itself. Like, in other words, I know about 45% of what we need to know to make it work. The rest of it will come outside. It's locked up in those other people's genetics. You understand what I mean? Like, in other words, it's behind their genetic codes. It's not behind mine. You know what I mean? To fully create it, if you understand what I'm talking about. You see what I'm saying? 45% of it, I know and can articulate and can give to anybody who wants to know how it will be done. You understand what I'm saying? I'm talking about window symbols, okay? I can give you all a little bit right now. I'll just give you a little, okay? If you have a personal computer at home, right, you have it consists of three parts. What are they called?
Motherboard, hard drive, processor.
Motherboard. Yeah.
Come on, motherboard. Okay, you got your, monitor. You got your monitor. You got your keyboard,
RAM.
Right? And what is what is that thing that you put next to the desk? What is that called? A what?
Mouse.
Hard drive.
A tower.
Tower.
Yeah. The
a tower, correct?
Right.
Yeah. A tower, right? Now let me ask you a question. In Al-Islam, did you know that when you looked at the old symbols in Al-Islam, you were looking at the symbols of fertility? The minaret was called the tower, right? Where they would call the athan, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the dome was a symbol of the breast, right? Which was in reference to the masjid, correct?
Yes, correct.
Are you understanding me thus far? I'm asking you.
Yes,
can you see that?
Yes.
Okay, okay, so, well, now let's think. Now think. You have a tower that sits alongside of the desk. Okay. Has anyone ever seen one of those old hair dryers that your mothers used to use a long time ago? That she sit it on the dining room table and it go cluck cluck and then it comes over the top of her head like that.
Yeah.
You ever seen those?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what it will be housed in. That's what window symbols will be housed in. And then we will connect it to the tower. Listen, then we will connect it to the tower. Listen, via USB cord.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Copy that.
That's as much as I can tell without getting everybody to sign non-disclosure forms.
Right.
You understand?
Yes.
I just gave you what the housing will be. You see, so it will all of it will represent fertility, but in cyber space. You follow me? This will not only cause the computer to move faster. Now, let me explain what I mean by that. picture being able to sit, first off, the best thing they got going right now is Windows 7. I don't give a damn what everybody say. I don't like Windows 8. I don't like Windows 9 or 10. You know what I'm saying? Windows 7, I think, is about the best thing that they've ever produced.
Cool.
Do you agree?
Yep, yep.
Because, I mean, what's going on? Are you good? Okay, now we got to get there before this place closes. We got 15 minutes. Straight down Broadway right there. Okay, now here's what's going to happen. You should go out that way. You don't want to go out this way. You want to go out that way.
Why?
Because
go
then the island right here. Go there. Go there. Don't pay me no mind. Hold on one second. Oh God. Let me put the seatbelt on. Oh shit. I don't know. I just gotta pay very close attention. Everybody's driving. Oh, and then angels got me on that. Oh God. Anyway. Well, in the desert you tie your camel, always remember that. I mean, you can depend on heaven all you want, but you better depend on yourself somewhere in that vibe. In that vibe. The helping hand you need is at any old risk. If you take the risk, you can use it. Okay, here we go. We're doing just fine. Not bad. Here you go, Mike. Proceed. Anyway, now, so, what was we talking about just now? We were talking about something. What was it? Anybody can remember?
Windows 7 is the best one.
Oh, Windows 7. Yeah, Windows 7 is the best thing they got right now. It will afford you 21 windows, but guaranteed if you open up 21 windows, your computer will slow down substantially. It might even freeze or crash. You understand what I'm saying? Now, imagine being able to open up 164 windows and your computer not skip a beat. And picture this. Picture being able to put your face in front of the monitor and say, I need to know how to fly a helicopter. Got it. And just that quick, you digest it as fast as the computer can put it out. That's what Windows symbols will afford you. You follow me?
Copy.
I had no idea when I was looking at the Matrix that I was looking at my own computer program that had yet to be invented. You understand? Damn.
Yes.
Now, that's why Sophia Stewart found her way onto our radio show. They stole her scripts. She wrote The Matrix, and she wrote Terminator. Now, what was Terminator about?
Saving the child.
It was about a woman named Sarah O'Connor, right?
Oh, yes.
Who was riding around with a little boy who was destined to invent something that would change the face of the planet, right?
Yeah.
Well, guess who's riding with me right now?
Yeah.
Sarah O'Connor. No bullshit.
Wow.
Are y'all understanding that?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's real tough, Sarah. You know that, don't you? This woman will live and die for me. She's sitting here right now. Everybody got a little wrinkles to iron out, but she's got a little couple of them, but she knows. And, yeah, let me tell you something.
15 minutes.
It's real. Better go. Go. Here. Let me give you the information. You get it, dog. Come here. Give me a pen. Pencil. Anything. Give me something to write on. I got to give you the numbers. Okay, listen. God damn, what is this?
Competition.
Okay. Okay, here we go. Write this down. Wait a minute. Okay, here we go. Hold on, you fellas. Hold on, family. Hold on. Okay. Dang, I feel. Okay, here we go. Okay, the number is 076-889-1933. Your name is Ramon Eli, okay, which is spelled R-A-M-O-N E-L-L-I. Okay, you understand, Kevin?
Yeah, I heard.
Now, the question is, what has no limits? The answer is God, okay?
Yeah.
You can remember that part, right?
Yeah.
Because it's going to be a test question. You just tell her it's a test question. She's going to ask you, what has no limits? The answer is darkness. Okay? Did you handle it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, she wrote everything down. You got 15 minutes. Okay. Now that can leave me on the phone talking to you guys. Yeah, but I had no, like, okay, so Sophia Stewart found her way onto our radio show, and she wrote The Matrix and Terminator. And Terminator is about a little boy who's going to invent something that will change the face of the planet. Okay, why do you think they keep calling me a little boy? Because of the alchemy of the what? The child.
Child.
See, they everybody in the Masonic community, even though I'm 58 years old, they look at me as the child. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And they know I'm the child. They know who I am. And they can just, and whoever does it, if they don't like it, they'll find out in a little while. Now, yeah, I'm telling I told you.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Last time you jumped on the bed.
Every day.
Let me tell you something. The alchemy of the child is the strongest alchemy that's ever been created. I brought it into existence thousands of years ago. Oh, my God. No. There is no other rest thing. There's nothing you can do. That's a done data. It's the done data. It's closed.
You can make it back to
Walgreens. There's another Walgreens.
There's the other Walgreens is on Springs.
The Springs Road, there's no way we can make it.
Man,
that's tearing my head up. I have absolutely no. I had just enough money to eat with. I ate. The money I needed was at the Western Union. Their system is down, and they're just taking no for an answer. Come in, Kevin. Kevin. You don't take no for an answer. Fuck that. Go in there and tell them to bring us. Ground and tell them again.
They won't do it.
They got to.
He said he's closed. The system shut down.
The system shut down my ass. Go in there and tell them to bring it up.
They won't. They're hard asses in there.
Try to talk to them. Do something. Yeah. Sarah. Come here. Yo, don't take no. Listen to me, Sarah. Come from underneath this hood. I've got to get this Western Union to get this money. Our people just accept defeat just so instantaneously. Don't you see when they tell you no, that don't mean shit. You press your will and then turn the face of the planet.
Oh.
You follow what I'm saying?
Oh. That's right, Chief.
Our people just accept whatever's happening to them. No, don't accept it. Well, it's be relentless. Keep shooting the jumper.
Mm-hmm.
Play hard in the paint. You understand me? That's how it's got to be, nigga. We playing for the divine love producer. We in the divine love playoffs. Nigga, we playing for the rings. We the lord of the rings, damn it. And we not playing around. We gonna win this. We gonna win this. It ain't no you might win. We already won. Shit, time to do this, damn it. Everybody's got to see it for what it's worth. Because I've been telling everybody for years now. I can't get it across to you any better than what I already have. You should be able to see it and hear it by now. See it, hear it, feel it, taste it, shit it, fart it.
That's
I don't care. It's got to be part of your makeup.
Oh.
It's got to be who you what? R.
R.
You feeling me? You feeling me, fam?
Yeah, I feel you, fam.
Yes, sir.
That's real. People just take no for an answer. Fuck no. I make the weather. I make the wind blow. How you gonna tell God no?
Oh.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Kevin, go in there and tell them motherfuckers you want the goddamn thing to work. Tell them. Tell them God said.
She's still in there, so they might be working
with her. Yeah, they're working with her.
Start a scene.
No, you don't have to. Tell them God said. Turn
their... They're going to laugh at me.
What? What'd they say? Something's got to happen. Well, fuck this. What we got to do then? I got 15 minutes. I got a minute. God, oh, man, we just blew it. Just all fucked off.
Okay.
All right, fam. Yeah. Thinking past this. You know, it's another way. Watch this. Dig deep. Watch this. I'm going to show y'all how this gets done. Watch. Okay, I want to Brandon. Tank. Damn it, Tank, are you there or what?
I'm here.
Okay, now listen to me. This is what I want done. I want you to go online right now, find out Western Union's, listen. I want to find out a Western Union open in Fairfield, California. I want to know what time they, what's the latest one they got open. Fairfield, Rodeo, like Pono, the cities that surround Vallejo.
Okay.
I want to know what time those Western Unions is closed.
Vallejo, California.
Fairfield,
who?
The surrounding cities. Fairfield, Pono, Crockett. Yeah, those are the ones. Fairfield, Pinole, or Crockett. Pinole and Crockett are going south. Fairfield's going north.
Are they all saying closed?
Huh?
They all saying closed. Fairfield, California, West Virginia, Fairfield, closed.
Okay, look, it's got to be a Western Union somewhere in the Bay Area. Type in to your search engine, Western Union open in the East Bay Area of California, of the state of California, East Bay Area of the state of California.
Got one open at Alamodo, California. Closes at 2 a.m.
Alameda at what time?
2 a.m. your time.
Ooh. 2 a.m.? Okay, where else?
1401 Western Street, Alameda, California, 945.
I know where that's at. I know exactly where that is. Now, where else? Do they have any other ones?
One second.
Okay, yo, listen. Go ahead, Brad.
I'm here, Steve.
Talk to me. I'm sorry to yell at you.
No, it's not here.
Yo, listen.
It's frustrating.
No, it's all right. You're fine.
Yeah. I'm finding
answers.
Okay.
He did not hear it, but I'll get it done. Your call's not going
to
happen. No. I'll get another vehicle. Come on, let's go back to, I got to go back up there to where Bowen is.
Okay.
It's incredible, man. These people. Now listen, I had the books in the both of them. Both of y'all should be able to, your book, if you turn your phones on, the books are there.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Oh, okay. I don't feel wrong.
Oakland, California closes at 10 soon.
That's the one there. Oakland, California, 10.
And one at Pack and Save, Emeryville, California, 24 hours.
Emeryville, and 20 for 24, that's the one. 24 hours in Emeryville?
Yep.
I know. It's all good. Jimmy, text me the address to all three of those spots. We won't take your call. We'll get another call. Can you hear me?
Yep.
Okay, and that I tell you, I'm good, nigga. I'm good. You never give up in the face of adversity. Listen, always learn this. When anybody tells you no, never accept no for an answer. Number one, no is a definite negative response. You see what I'm saying? Don't tell me no when I'm spending my money. You understand what I'm saying? Always know that no is a definite negative response. And it's got to be confronted by something just as powerful, which is your will to make it something, to make it change into something else. You see what I'm saying? How are we going to change the face of the planet if we just accept everything the way it is and accept everything that they've been telling us? No, you got to stop accepting it. And somewhere down the line, say no, back to them. You see? And then we'll start to change the face of the planet merely behind the fact that we all collectively see it this way.
Oh.
If all of us agree that tomorrow red, the color red will be orange, or the color red will be blue, then tomorrow the color red will be blue if we all agree.
Yes,
ma'am.
How do I get everybody to see this stuff? How do I get everybody to see it? And I'm going to get us all to see it, trust me. I ain't gave up. I ain't leaving you this time, y'all.
Thank you.
You're not understanding.
Thank you.
My last time, I left everybody. I left you. I said it's expedient that I leave you. Because there was many things y'all couldn't bear, and y'all couldn't deal with it then, and I knew it. Well, no, wait a minute. I wasn't sent to the whole planet then. I'm sent to the whole planet now. You know, and the truth of the matter is, I said, yes, it's expedient that I leave you, because if I don't leave you, and I didn't say the comforter will not come. I said comfort will not come your way, because growth is not promoted through a state of comfort. It's promoted through a state of discomfort. What I was saying to you all is, if I don't leave you, you all are going to constantly be uncomfortable with me around, because I'm going to keep telling y'all what you need to fucking know. You see, and that's just the way it was, and that's the way it still is to a certain degree. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to stop, but this time I'm not leaving you.
Okay,
I'm not leaving you. I'm here with you. We're going to do this, and we're going to ride this out until everyone, until the whole world, not the W-H-E-E-L-S, the W-I-L-L-S falls off.
Okay.
Once those wills, all those people, those wills who think their willpower is so strong against what's right, and think they know what's right and want to tell you what's right, when indeed they don't even know their damn selves. Right is defined by someone else other than you, and that's not right for you if you just knew what it was I was talking about and where it is I was coming from, too. You should know that. No one should have the power to define right and wrong for you.
Right. That's
How
right.
can somebody come along and say that's right for you? That's wrong for them to even try. Don't you see that?
Right. That's right. And error.
You understand what I'm telling you? Huh?
I said then.
I'm trying to tell you, babe, listen to me, y'all. It's so majorly important that you get this. Get this, else they'll continue to make you slaves somewhere in it all. And I, what I've been telling y'all is seek for the truth and you will find it, and the truth will make you free.
Great.
I didn't say set you, I say make you. And nobody ever took the time to say free from what? Free from the lie. The power of decision. I'm saying these people have defined for you everything. What's right, what's wrong, what's up, what's down, what's in, what's out, what's side to side. Good God. Makes me want to cry to see how far my people have fallen. And what you all need to pull you up now. And I'll be damned if I got to do it by myself. I'll pull you up by the bootstraps, damn it. Until all of y'all rise. Each and every one. And I'm not leaving not one out. Now, both free and tall, rich and bondage, all that good shit. I don't give a damn. You, all you niggas coming with me.
That's right.
You understand?
Overstood.
Because I love you, and I'm not leaving that now one of mine nowhere.
We love you.
That's real talk. Do you understand? That game is fine. I'm about to I'm telling you to be quiet and stop playing the game while you're talking
for me.
To be paying attention, I'm talking, son.
I'm
no, stop multitasking. Multitasking divides your energy. You can't win if you stand divided amongst yourselves from the start. And stop subtracting. Subtracting only makes you weak. When you add and multiply. Division's not good, and neither subtraction. Not in this family. Not in this family. You got understood?
Overstood, Chief.
Not bad, y'all. Hey, guys. You was good. Group hug, niggas. Group hug.
Group hug, group hug.
That's a good thing. Yeah, yeah, nigga. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Damn right. We gonna get it right, fam. We get it right. The whole globe gonna be right.
We grateful for
I said
you,
so.
We grateful.
That we grateful. I'm grateful for y'all. Lord love you. Each and every one of y'all is mine. Every one of you. Mine. Yeah. That's right. Mine. Every one of you.
My name is that too. Right. My
don't
name
you
is
know,
that
I was the nigga. I was the nigga that was there to pick you up when you fell and hurt your knee. I was the nigga that was there in your grandma's hug. I was the
Thank
nigga.
You.
You didn't know? Well, now you do. I was the nigga, yeah I was. The pledge when you ain't had no food. I was the nigga. He gave
Thank
you
me.
Clothes when you were cold outside. Said, come here, try put this on. I was the nigga. You didn't hear me? Me, that's who. You hear what I say?
Yes.
That's right. Said, come here, child, put this on. And they smile and you smile at me, and I smile back. You give you a big hug. That was me. You didn't know, but now you do. You understand?
Yes.
I'm going to keep loving you all the days of your lives. Ain't nothing you can do to stop me if you try. Don't need your permission. Don't need your permission at all. I can love you no matter how many times you fall, niggas. How many times you fall and how many times I got to be here to pick you up. And I'll pick you up as many times as I got to because I love you and I ain't never going nowhere.
Thank
ever.
You. Thank you.
Been with you
Thank
all
you.
The days of your lives and going to be there even further still. You didn't know, but now you do. I'm everything that was good, everything that was you thought to be good. Nigga, that was me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And that word that you can't find that in no book, neither. Can't find that in no book.
Nah.
Shit. Only in right. One book you find that, in the book of life. Shit. Who wants to read the book of the dead? Bunch of niggas been scared. Only one they say is alive is me in the spirit. But I ain't alive in no spirit, nigga. I'm alive in the flesh. Right here with your ass. Now what? Now what? Yeah, so only coming out the book of life. Shit. Shit. You know what's that? We're coming out. We're writing a page in the book of life right now. Shit. But like that brother, I say, give your testimony. Remember that brother gave his testimony on YouTube? Them is books right there. You didn't know? Those the books that are tomorrow's Bible. You didn't know? Well, I'm told you got to do is talk about how you met me. That's all you got to do. We'll be right tomorrow's Bible. Child, it'll be done in video. A video coming off of YouTube right there for the whole family to see. All the niggas praising the Most High, coming to the Most High. Don't nobody get to the Father except by way of me. You understand?
Yes.
That's how we'll do it. We'll write tomorrow's Bible. Shit, every person and every being will need it. In video, shit, nigga, you didn't know, but now you do.
Now you do.
Shit, you'll be able to see it, everybody. The what that brother name was, that brother that was shoot, he put it down with the music behind. That nigga wasn't playing, that nigga was doing the damn thing. What, who y'all talking to? Soul Train ain't derailed in this house. Shit, nigga, please, I cut a rug, too. I ain't scared. I got moves. Y'all niggas ain't seen this nigga, dude. I doze this shit. You can get me out there with you, boy. I might be old, but I ain't cold, goddamn.
That's right.
Nah, yeah, I'll get out there and cut a rug with you, too. Y'all be like, look at Pops go. Look at Pops out here doing his thing. The Pops doing his thing. Pull over there. Pull over. We ain't in no hurry. He ain't in no hurry. Shit. I got moves. Yeah, I do the damn. I blew the James Brown on you. What? I want to get up and do my thing, you know. Shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. You have to tell somebody. Yeah.
All right.
I love y'all.
Love you.
What that brother name is, I want to see that nigga on video. Wait, hey, go to YouTube. I remember the brother Anthony did one, came out fat. He had the spaceship shit looking on his face and shit, the glowing shit.
That was Shining Brave.
That was Ant. Yeah, that nigga put that shit in motion. You had to know it did. That nigga said, yo, he said it's been like a river. And then the nigga just fell over. That shit made me laugh like a motherfucker. He had that. I said, that nigga, that's my nigga. Yeah, that's a book right there. You didn't know that's the book of Ant right there. Nigga, fuck that. Because I said so. That's tomorrow's Bible. You understand what I'm saying? All you got to do is give your testimony about how you come in contact with me, what I've done for your life, what I've been doing. We write tomorrow's Bible. Y'all didn't know? Now you do. Come on, ride it with me. Shit. Do the best you can do, too. Because I'm here for you. Becomes the question, you
I'm
know?
Able.
Sure.
Yes,
that's right. I'm able to. We all able. Ain't no canes in this house. Canes is an excuse. I love y'all. Let me
love
get off this
love
phone because I think I done went crazy. There ain't no woe. Ain't no woe around this motherfucker. You be watching these lanes and you switch over and I'm in this car. Shit. Hell, you mean woe. Shit. And then you know, I'm shook by that car accident shit. That shit was no joke. I'm still shook up. I be cussing motherfuckers out behind the wheel these days. What the hell you mean, nigga? Shit, motherfucker drives right. Shit. I be serious about it, too. It ain't gonna kill me in California. No, they try. Try to get me a couple of times. I'm, you know, too, I'm putting dye in my hair. I'm having some dye. I'm not gonna let y'all see me gray and white hair quite a thing out the game yet. Y'all see me quite a thing up, y'all gonna really like y'all gonna be like, look at Pop. That nigga was lying. White as a motherfucker. Hey, white as a fuck. Y'all gonna be like, look at this nigga here. But I'll be fly though. Motherfucker can't tell me I ain't fly.
I be fly as a motherfucker. Yeah, I do. Even on a bad day. Nigga, even when I'm looking down, I look good, nigga. Shit. I look good. You got the standard representation of the best at Tomb Raider himself. He ain't never seen Father look anything less than fantastic. Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Oh, mm-hmm.
True. Yeah.
Father
looks fantastic every day. Yeah. Man, is that Ben Witness or what? Shout it out. Who that come on the line? I love you too. Who is you?
This is
this. What's your name?
What's your
name, loved one?
Hey,
what's going on, loved one? How you do?
Everything.
I love you, Yasu. What's happening with you?
I love you.
It's good to hear your voice. Yes, sir. That's right. We love it in this camp. Whole lot of love in this house.
Yeah, it is.
Yes, sir.
Love lives here.
I just want to touch base with everybody. Who calling? Is somebody calling? I got somebody calling on the other line. Oh, Lord. You got to find Josie there, too. She's still stuck out in the wilderness. Whole thing.
You take care of my son, my friend.
About who?
Peasy.
Yeah, he's going to take care of her. He don't know how to take care of damn self. Oh, that mother. Hey, look at him.
Can we go in?
Yeah, we got to be.
Who's that?
Whoever he is. Hey, yo, hey, Kev, get out and check his ass real quick.
Come on.
If you need to knock him out, knock him out.
We don't do that.
Yeah, well, Kev is here for that. That's what he's here to do, shit. Shit. I got one or two good ones around me. Yeah, I do. You think I don't? Shit, the most I gonna play. Yeah, I got one or two good ones. They love me. I love them. Love them, shoot. They ain't gonna let nothing happen to their last chance. You see? Crazy. After me, ain't no more. Shit. Y'all better get it while you right can. Shit, the turn of life comes right through this
right.
Yeah, right here.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. Turn of life comes right through this hand right here. With my hand is on.
Yeah.
Y'all didn't know. That's how I go. As I go, it's some loving, it's some good loving stuff too. Love is showing up all the way
stuff.
There.
I can see my way because of you.
I know.
What say, love one? I think I might not be plugged in.
I said I can see my way because of you.
This one.
I can see my way because of you.
You can see it. And you want to know something? I hope you can see even clearer now than ever before. Because, Lord, we still got a little ways to go, but not much, though. Not much. We close now. Shit, yeah. Did you know I got a brother called me just a minute ago from Mexico City. He wanting to get in where he can fit in. Yeah, that's right. And I make sure he get there, too. Make sure he get there. Mexico City. And from London and from overseas, the next thing you know, they'd be calling me from Japan. Here I am.
Yeah.
I'm still alive. That's my friend right there. My friend, let that brother around him. That's my friend. I love him. I've known that nigga for years. Yeah, it's Charlie. Watch him, though.
I got
him. Watch him.
I have a question, Chief. I got a question, Chief.
Yeah, what's going on?
What do they refer to you in the Incan tradition? Like, what do they call you?
Where at? When?
In the Incan family, Incan side of the family. What name do
they have
for the
family? They call me the sun that shines, but I can't pronounce it in their language where you will understand.
Oh.
I don't know how to pronounce, but what it means the sun that shines. That's what they call it. That's what they call it.
Thank you.
Beloved, may I ask you a question?
It's more than not a pronunciation. It's in a script. It's in a writing. You understand what I mean?
Okay. Yes. Yes, Chief.
Some characters they never gave sounds to. You understand?
But
yes,
you knew what they meant when you read them, if you from that culture, if you understand what I mean.
Yes.
But that's what it meant, though. That's why I couldn't give sound to it, because they never gave sound to those characters. But basically what it means is the sun that shines. That's what they call me in that language.
Thank you.
Just like the sand paintings of the Hopi Indians are almost identical to the hieroglyphics on the walls of ancient Tamaray. It's all in the writing. It's in the expression, how it is expressed. And then certain ones along the way gave each character a sound, and then a language was invented. You know, an alphabet, and then so on and so forth. That's how I'll be inventing. That's how I'll be writing the language of the Shagadatin tribe. I'll be creating it from root to branch. You follow me? From root to branch, we'll create our own language called the language of the Shagadatin tribe.
Yeah.
New Native Americans. That's right, that they'll have to give validity to, because we'll lay claim and be telling the truth that we are descendants of the Shoshone tribe. Damn right, motherfuckers better get a can and get right. Give us everything we do, a registry number, all that shit. I want it all, damn it, and I'm not playing. I'm serious about it, too. Motherfucker, it's far too long when they say you shall come out with great substance. That's what I mean, too. That's what Pops meant. He said, you're going to come out with great substance. You're damn right. All ours going to have everything they need and some. Before heaven on earth materialize. That's right. You're going to live till good. That's before heaven on earth come. Shit. You're going to live, that's right. And you're going to have everything you all need. And then you're going to realize, and then turn the light to come. You got to get this house, the table spread. See, I didn't tell y'all about the table spread. I didn't tell you about it.
Nope, nope.
It's a celebration. We get in the house. The back of the house, I've seen it many times, a vision. The house going to be about two blocks. The back porch going to be about two blocks long. Three blocks long, the back porch. Now, picture how big this house is. And me and Pop's going to be sitting there old as Methuselah. Gray hair on, going out the winter way. And then I'm be old too. Listen, gonna be so many people there. I'm gonna tell my wife, wash her feet. She gonna wash feet gladly. Tell my wife, get him some lemonade. She get him some lemonade. And then a little boy gonna run up the steps to me. And I'm gonna say, come here, boy. You look like me. You one of mine. I know you. What's your name? He's going to say, you know me, Abu. And I'm going to say, what's your name? He say, Tahuti. And right then, everybody on the planet going to turn young. 35 years old, no older. And eternal life will begin that day.
Amen.
Because Tahuti would have personified in my son. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah, God's father will personify in my son. And let me tell y'all something. Woo-wee, what a day that's going to be. You're going to see rolling hills with people. Far as I can see, playing badminton, volleyball, barbecuing, chilling, running everywhere. So many you can't count. And let me tell you, we all going to be there. Everybody going to be there watching to see. Everybody you know. Except for them knuckleheads. You know the ones. And they will be the ones who cancel themselves out from such a great thing. Don't you know heaven was intended for everybody to have to enjoy? We wanted y'all to be there. But so many just were so stupid. So stupid. I mean, many people, heaven was intended for everybody on the planet to enjoy.
Yeah.
But so many people just canceled the damn stuff out. Beethoven, turn the clock off. Turn the alarm off. This is not right. Turn it off so many damn times and they never come on again.
You know, this is not right, this is not part of the Walking Dead. Stay there, damn fools. See, but let me tell you something. You know how you use your alarm go off? What is that smell?
Yeah, is it?
It's soap powder. What the hell y'all trying to do to me?
Take it out.
Lord have mercy. They're trying to gag a nigga in here now. Shoot. What the hell is it? Want me to open the door?
It's the spray to kill
the shit. It's killing my ass too. Shit. Now, that was saying, the nigga reach over, alarm clock go up, say, this is not right, this is not right. You reach over and turn it off. What you don't know is when you're trying to turn it off, when it go up again, this is not right, they don't go up as loud. You go, this is not right, this is not right. Then you reach over and turn it off, and you go, this is not right, this is not right. Reach over and turn it off, this is not right, this is not right. And next thing you know, don't go up at all. You have now become a part of the Walking Dead. But let me tell y'all something. As a mercy to you all from my father, through me. Listen now. Sparks turn into flame. Love can burn once again. And I know you know. Whenever you need me, I'll be there. You hear what I say? So even the Walking Dead, even them, when I touch them, that light will come on again, and they'll have opportunity at living in forever, eternal life with us all. Heard what I say?
Yes.
Yes, beloved.
Because sparks turn into flame, and love can burn once again. And I know you know, whenever you want me, I'll be there. Whenever you need me, I'll be there. I'll be around. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, yeah, motherfucking fight. Don't you know it, man? Yeah, that's that good shit. That's that good shit. That's that good shit for real. The motherfucker better ask somebody. If they don't know now to do right.
I heard that jam the other day on the radio.
I'm saying we got to understand where it's coming from. Don't you know every song that ever come out the skies have come from us to you? It's been invented by love, brought into existence by love, sent down to you by love. Every word, every syllable. And I'm divine love personified, so what makes you think I can't tap in anytime I want? Anytime I want, nigga. Shit, anytime I want. And you think you are too, if you just shut up, child, long enough, shit. That's all right, I'll get you there some type of way. Hear what I say? I am. I'm still alive. They tried to get me. Yeah, I'm still alive. The motherfucker Charlie, I'm just trying to get my ass. That look nice. That look nice. What this thing is? That Native American there, boy, you like that? I like that. You got that thing. Huh? For some work you? Good. Where you got your what? Which car? This is the gray one? That's good. But shoot, can I park over here and not have no problem?
All right, well, now?
Yeah.
Park right now, just keep it down.
Okay, cool.
No,
no, I got to go over there and find out what's going on with Bowen, then I got to go find that bumper. Huh? No, I got to find out what went on with Bowen, because he's dead now. What the hell are you doing, woman?
I
already heard about it. I got it. No, none of us do. None of us do.
I know
he straighten it out. He don't even. It was some old. It was a.
I got you. We gonna work it out.
No, where's Mark? Where Mike Mark went? I mean,
Friend, you want to go find the. You want to go find
Go ahead.
Is that Bo right
there? No, that ain't Bo. Oh, my stomach hurting me.
You want some Sprite or something?
Nah. I'm
supposed to help you.
I've got to go down here. Shit.
Yeah, well, you're going back to Highway 37. Go down Highway 37. Go down there. No, I got to get my shit from this nigga. Yeah. Shit, I done got all jammed up for the rest of the night with this. Oh, shit. Oh, fine. I ain't forgetting about shit. Anybody on this phone?
Oh, yes, Chief.
Okay, good. Okay, somebody forget about lying. The key is to remember everything. I remember it all. I don't forget about nothing. Shit, I'm remembering everything. Going down there, see the boy down there with the shit.
What?
See his bow down there and tell him I say come in.
That's what I was doing.
That's a good move. That's the best move we made all night. Besides eating.
You're
cute. She called you cute, but stop looking at the man. Yeah, he's a good thing. That's a good thing. Okay, yeah, that's good. That's a good thing. Yeah, you put butter on my fingernails. It worked, too.
Yeah,
that's not bad. That's why I put my fingernails in there.
Oh, yeah. Are you a doctor?
Foot on
where I'm one of my kids,
and
I noticed he's working around a tree.
I
said he wasn't feeling it.
Oh, so good. Oh, feel good. I feel great. I'm sleepy. I have to eat, and I'm sleeping now. I'm sleepy. I'm ready to sleep. Hey, family? Family?
Yes, Chief.
I had two women combing in my hair. Combing my hair,
right.
And doing everything that any grown man
could
possibly do. They're loving me. They love me. Oh, please. I know how to pamper. I don't need to be pampered. I'm a man,
yeah.
Yeah,
that's what
you do. That's the gentlemen. Them gentlemen.
No,
that's the
no.
Faggots out there. That's a gentleman, a gentleman. You ever heard some shit like that? A gentleman. Ain't that some shit?
Like, you take time out to love us or help us or be there when we're tired.
Yeah, but I'm not no gentleman.
All the way, all the time being helping. Then it's our turn sometimes to help.
Oh, well, we love you to help us.
It's
beautiful.
Yeah.
But don't call me no gentleman. I'm not no gentleman.
I
know you didn't. Whoever said, there was this, oh, he's a gentleman. Yeah, he's a faggot.
But in our language, I remember, in this terminology, when we say
that,
you mean that he's not good looking or that he's acting with man.
I know, he's a faggot.
Remember,
the
language
is
technology.
I mean,
do you say
funky boy?
He's a faggot,
yeah, you know, he's gay.
Might be straight.
Yeah, I'm straight. I'm not straight. I'm gay, is what they be saying. The motherfuckers. Yeah, boy. Yeah, you need to tell that to new boy down there. Well, I had to tell him. I said, man, I bet you if all of us start whipping your ass every time you put lipstick on and the wigs on your head, motherfucker, I bet you come up out that shit then. If you just try to, even if you is feminine, nigga, just try to be masculine, nigga. I'd help your ass be a man. Nah, fuck that. I bet you a nigga whip his ass every time he put a lipstick to his face. You stop it. Stop that shit then. That's what I told him, man. Because I told him to hear this nigga. We letting you sit around us. Men. We sitting in here with women and you sitting here with us. What niggas outside of here thinking? We fucking you too? Oh, man. Nigga, you got to do something about this wig and lipstick shit. But I told him, I said, man, you better. His name Trey. That's what his name is. He walk around talking about his name, Nunu, he a punk. Man, that boy better stop dressing like a girl. I said, man, what's wrong with you? Something's wrong with your brain, son. You're not a woman. Get that shit straight. Look at you. Look in the mirror. You are not a woman. You are a man. I had to tell him that shit. Ain't that a damn shit? I tell you, I bet you if we start whipping your ass every time you put lipstick on yourself. We can park wherever we want to. I'm God, woman, God, son. Ain't got to fuck it up.
So, you know,
you'll figure it out, though. Hey, baby, I'm going to turn Lulu around. He's going to be a man when I finish with him. Danger?
Yeah.
You talking about Danger?
Yeah,
I'm going to turn him around, too. I'm going to turn his ass around, too. That motherfucker's crazy. But he don't do that shit with me. He don't play that shit. He be just as manly and act right when he around my ass.
He'll be
honest.
The,
Hell no, don't never flirt with me. That nigga don't never, just like the motherfucker, the big homosexual, the one that sing with E-40. The one that sing with E-40. Nah, he been out for a while. It's a big one, big dummy. I mean, he was in locked up, and I was locked up in Folsom. They didn't play that shit. Nah, the motherfucker told him, you can't be a faggot in here. You got to be a man. That nigga straightened up and flew right.
Wow.
Yeah, he did. But that little time he was in Folsom, yeah, he did. Went on the yard with that shit.
Because usually, guys don't spend too long, they end up...
Nah, in these days, if you a man, you going to be a man around men. You ain't going to be no faggot around men. Nah, niggas don't play that shit no more. You come up here talking about you a woman, if you want to, we going to fuck you up. Make you figure it the fuck out. Now, you ain't no woman no more, is you? Your lip busted, your eye bleeding. Yeah, now, nigga. You a woman, but you a motherfucker come about that shit. Bet you that. You feel me? Now. Yeah. Be a homosexual on this yard if you want to. They tell Levitty, that's his name. The faggot that be singing with E-40 and them, Levitty. He a big, big dummy. I'm talking about this motherfucker huge, too. And he used to call himself a faggot. On the yard of Folsom, they wasn't having that shit. They told Levitty, yo, you'll be a faggot in here if you want to. He's finna fuck you up. And that nigga did the Hebrew.
Shout out, beloved. You went out, beloved. We can't hear you now.
He said his phone was on 2%. I don't know if he plugged it in. Shout it out, brother.
Shout it out, brother. Pariel. I was asleep when you called me, baby. I just woke up out of sleep. You know, they was having this after birthday dinner for me. I just woke up, beloved.
It's all good. Perfect timing.
Just woke up, beloved.
It's all good, my brother.
I wanted to talk to him and just tell him, and just pour my heart out to him and tell him, even though I don't have the funds, I'm doing everything that I can do, being fishermen of men, you know, using the energy that's lighter than that of the lightest atom, which is hydrogen. You understand what I'm saying? To bring brothers to Osiris and to do whatever it is that I can do until the monetary game come, beloved, because once they come, I definitely will be showering my love with that as well, beloved. So if he was to have just divine patience with me, beloved, he'll see by the fruit that my tree bears that, you know, I love him with all my heart, beloved. I wanted to let him know that before he got off the line. Because it's serious to me, beloved, because I know I don't have money right now to be able to give him things when he need it at the time where he get it. But at the same time, I feel him where he coming from because, beloved, if it weren't for the goddess, I'd be out there as well, you know. So it's serious to me, but I just love the fact that he's loving as he is. You understand what I'm saying? I heard him through the blog talk radio. I heard him through the blog talk radio say, if one of us didn't have, you know, any monetary gain to get him for a book, you understand what I'm saying? You know, he'll still send a book. We just sent it at our leisure, and that was just confirmation that he's the real Messiah himself. You understand what I'm saying? Because he's not doing it for entrepreneurship and gain. But, of course, in the physical, we have to balance our physical and keep it going because, you know what I mean? Like, this form isn't going to survive off just divine love and communication alone. We're going to have to get something going. You dig where I'm coming from? We're going to have to get some currency for them because we're all electrical beings. You dig where I'm coming from? And without the electricity flowing, you dig, like, it's no power circuit, you know, going through the circle. So we have to have electricity going through the circle because we must understand money doesn't even exist. It's currency. You dig where I'm coming from? And that's Pata's law. Currency plays a part. Pata's law. You understand what I'm saying? So I just definitely wanted to let them know that. You know what I mean? And for that, to keep us in divine love, because we need everybody in this circle. We need all forms, all schools of thoughts, all gangs, all foot soldiers. You know what I mean? Both yeti be agreeable or disagreeable. We need them all. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So with that being said, I just wanted to let them know that. But, you know, I'm knowing how Chief be. You know, he'll be going in. He old school, not knowing that he needs to put their phone on the charger because the joint will go out. You know, but hey, my elders, at least I let my elders know, somebody relay the message. Shout out to my family.
Shout out, beloved.
Shout out, brother.
Ooh. Shout out.
Shout out, young elder.
Oh, Pyrell, I was asking in the chat that picture you posted.
Yes.
Lebec, who is that?
Oh, Jebek. I'm not sure who that is.
No, well,
I ain't never heard of him. Yeah, I have to look that one up myself.
Beloved brother Apar,
yes sir.
Elder, you listening to me, beloved? Like I said, I'm with the goddess and her. I basically, you know, my birthday was yesterday, and I allow the goddess's family to basically do a seafood broil for me, in a sense, as basically. Kind of like a ceremonial type of thing of me and the goddess kind of, in a sense, getting back together and me allowing her parents and her grandparents and all the elders of on her side, letting them know that, hey, I'm accepting your daughter with full loving and compassion, and I'm accepting you all to be mine, in a sense. So with that being said, you dig where I'm coming from? Like, I don't want to be disrespectful to them, but it's no fear of divine love. I had to step out of here. I seen that Chief was on the line. You dig where I'm coming from, so I had to step outside. Mm-hmm. But they probably don't understand why I'm out here right now, and I don't want to be disrespectful. So if I could get all of the compassion from all the elders, you know what I mean, to just understand, like, would it be okay if I conjuring this call tomorrow, since Chief is off the line now. I don't know if he's gonna get back on the line. You know, I love you, beloved. You know, time doesn't. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna be fine. You know, this is my life. You know what I mean? I would.
Yeah.
You know, I don't even say I die for this because I know how strong my words are, you know what I mean? I got hit by a car off my words. You dig? Like, I'm living.
You live for this.
I'm living for this. You dig where I'm coming from? Like, and it's not a game. It's not a game. Y'all growing me up. Y'all rearing me in the most positive fashion. You understand what I'm saying? And I love that I'm home. But if I could just get your divine love and companionship, if you mind, if y'all mind me getting back to them, because I just seen my stepfather-in-law just come outside to check, seeing what I was doing. But, you know, they respect my tones in the sense they know I'm about what I'm about. So I guess he didn't say anything out of the way, but I don't want to do anything too much. I'll go back in and say, I have to fellowship.
That's right. Keep the peace. Yes, yep. Right. Keep the tranquility. We support that 100%. Shout out to
Dr.
Brother.
I love you all, beloved. You know what I mean?
It's a beautiful brother.
Soon, ASAP, it may be an hour or so later on. I know my brother's long-winded, beloved, and I know we over. I may be back home in about an hour or so, and everybody be back online. I might chime in, and we talk for about another 2 or 3 hours. But I love you all. I'm gonna have to join this call later or tomorrow.
All right, now.
Yep.
Shout it out.
All right, shout it out, beloved.
Mm-hmm. Any announcements?
I don't know if Tank is still on or not.
You still there, Tank? Well, this was a beautiful treat.
Yeah, I'm glad to know. Hey, Chief, all right, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Mm-hmm. Good to hear your tones, Elder.
Did you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you. I said good to hear your tone. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Good to hear your tone too, bro.
Yeah. You heard Chief mention the Lord of the Rings?
Yeah. 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 Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I was going to ask him about that. I was going to ask him about what, why do they call it cyber? Cyber. I guess
okay.
That.
Cyber.
Yeah.
That's what they call Lord of the Rings? Cyber?
No, I was saying about, he was saying about cyberspace. I was going to ask him what is cyber. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I know they use the term cyborg and you know, then they say cyberspace. Mm-hmm. I was trying.
Uh-huh.
I started using it. Yeah, what's behind that term cyber?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Mm-hmm. It said that fertility is going to be put in cyberspace. Through the window symbol. Window symbols. Yeah.
Okay.
Powerful, though. That's powerful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going over. It was a family tree, and it was breaking down from the family tree about Mesopotamia. You know how all the different the different names and everything. And just studying that area.
Okay. Wasn't there a lot of experiments going on there in Mesopotamia?
I'm not sure, but I know it was certain things that was going on. Like when I came away with teaching us about how Tahuti and his brother, Hanana, and he had Mesopotamia, and then Tahuti established Tamale. He was breaking that down about that, explaining to us, but he didn't really elaborate, because he like they tell a story, but our story being told is different from a different perspective.
Okay.
Yeah. But you sound like you know. When I say you sound like you know, you familiar. I'm not familiar at all with certain guys in Mesopotamia. Mesopotamia, to me, and I think of Mesopotamia, I think of what, like Persia, some other Persia, the Greece. In that area.
Your sound sounds a little like fuzzy, like your reception sounds, your speaker sounds fuzzy.
Can you hear me good now?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay. Yeah, my speaker probably had. Nah, I was saying that, Mesopotamia that I'm familiar with, like the Persia and Greece area, and from Persia to Greece, but I'm not sure.
Okay. I know Atun Ray referenced the statement Mesopotamia where they messed everything up that pertains to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
But looking at who's there and who's like was in the region during certain time periods, you know, it can give some clues as to what was going on there, you know.
Yep. Just trying to remember it. What you gonna do for today, later on today?
Right now, I'm just sitting in the park. It's a lot of tall trees and grass. I'm enjoying the night air. And tomorrow, I'm gonna cut the grass for my mother. I'm gonna go to the house early in the morning and cut the grass. Yeah.
Yeah. Why it's still cool for that sun stuff?
Yeah. Coming up.
Yeah.
Enough.
But sometimes it'd be good to get a good workout like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
interacting with the earth is really energizing,
mm-hmm.
to say the least.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think I'm going to go visit my pops tomorrow.
Okay.
Go visit him. Today, my daughters, they visit me. We had a meal at this little Cajun restaurant.
Mm, okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was like a graduation related or?
No, it was just today for Father's Day for tomorrow.
Okay.
So they came. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, happy Father's Day to you.
Yeah, thank you, bro.
Yeah.
Well, I'm get on up and go clean this microwave. My wife was forcing me.
All right, bro. I think I'm going to get off here, too. I'm going to get off here, too. I appreciate you, beloved.
All right, shout it out, bro.
Shout it out. Shout it out, family.